And thank you, Purpose by God Outreach Ministries, for allowing me to have this opportunity. Again, shout out to everyone who came out to support me. I mean, y'all kind of shout out yourselves. before we get started, I'm going to tell you a few things about myself. So I've attended Rama Christian Academy for 8 years. I've gone to Summit Worship Center for about 3 years. I don't know how long I've been in a church, 5 years. And while at school club, I'm a Christian Academy, I've had all A's the whole time.
Amen.
While also having a man on extracurricular activities such as football, basketball, track, drama club, honor choir, and I'm a member of the Junior High Honor Society.
All right.
Father God, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you, Lord, for the opportunity that we have to listen to your word, hear your word, God. Help me to use me as a vessel, God, so that I can share your word.
Amen.
People in this room, God, thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. And Father, we ask that you have your way.
Amen.
All right. Well, if you're taking notes, I'll be talking from the title, Faith Will Set You Free.
Faith will set you free.
Faith will set you free.
Come on, that's good. That's good.
I have 5 points talking about faith, and they will be quick. And so, if you're taking notes, it's okay though.
It is okay.
Yes. Oh. Okay, we have time. Chew on all of Hebrews chapter 11.
Hebrews chapter 11.
That's good.
If you have your Bible, we'll give you a chance.
Hebrews. I can't get to it with one hand. Hebrews.
Amen.
He said Hebrews chapter 11, verses 1 through what?
Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1 through 3.
All right.
Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for.
Okay.
Substance. The conviction of things not seen.
Uh-huh.
By it, the people of old received their commendation.
You read another version.
By faith, we understand that the universe was created by the word of God, so that what is seen was not made out of things that are visible.
Mm.
I'll read that again, but I'm going to break it down just a little bit.
All right.
Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for.
Yes.
Which is a complete trust in something we don't have, but we want. But conviction, a firmly held belief, not loosely held, but firmly held, of things not seen, whereby it the people of old received their commendation, which is an award. By faith, which faith is having complete trust in God, we understand that the universe was created by the word of God, so that what is seen was not made out of things that are visible. And in the grand scheme of things, this verse means that if you have complete trust, you are promised to be rewarded with freedom, even when you can't see where that freedom is coming from.
Mm. Okay.
It's good. It's good.
Right. So if you need to be set free of anything, the answer is to have faith. Faith will set you free. All right. Number one. Faith is believing for the best, even when things look the worst.
Mm.
This reminds me of the story of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Yeah, it's good.
They refused to bow down to the king, but only to the one true Lord. And you guys know the rest of the story. The king was furious and threw them into the fiery furnace. I can't imagine anything looking worse than being put in the fiery furnace. And because of their faith that God will protect them, he delivered them out of their trouble. He was right there with them and rescued them. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were fully submissive to God. Because of that, they received a giant reward. They were freed from the fire. Not only did they not burn, no one could smell the smoke on them.
Come on now.
That's good.
You guys have probably heard people preach about faith over and over and over again.
Yeah.
But I'm not here to pressure you to do it. I'm here to encourage you on how it can benefit you.
Mm.
You will not be consumed, and no one will be able to tell you what you've been through. Think about this real quick. Have you ever been asked to bow down to something or someone you knew was wrong and refused? No matter how hot it got, you didn't bow down. I don't know about you, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
Amen. Come on, it's here.
Faith is believing for the best, even when things look the worst. Mm. Faith will set you free.
Yes, it will. Mm.
All right. So number one was faith is believing for the best, even when things are the worst. Number two, faith is knowing God's got you, even when life doesn't go your way. Mm. Yeah. I like to think of this as the story of both Job and Joseph. So let's start with Job. Job at one point had everything until he was put under the ultimate test. He allowed the devil to take everything he loved. He could have easily cursed God for doing nothing wrong but receiving all that punishment.
Yeah.
Even his wife thought it was a good idea to curse God. This is when faith gets the hardest. When you must choose to believe either those around you,
come on, that's
your peers and your family members.
Yeah.
You know, the ones who tell you to do this when you should do that, or the one who made you.
Yeah.
Job decided to press forward in what he knew was true. He trusted God would provide in every situation. Have you ever lost everything? Has God ever allowed the devil to take away the thing you love the most?
How did you thought?
Yeah.
Come on.
Has anyone ever told you you should curse God? Did you have the faith to know God had you even when life wasn't going your way? When you have that faith, just like Job, God will give you back double the amount you have before.
Yes. Amen. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's clear.
Come on, now, it's
clear. Same thing goes with Joseph. He had so many instances where life didn't go his way. He was sold into slavery by his brothers. Not just some random person, his own brothers.
Come on, man, talk about it.
That's tough.
Jesus.
He was accused of adultery by Potiphar's wife, and then he was imprisoned. Again, things were not going his way. He also could have easily cursed God for doing nothing wrong. Not because they were perfect, but they really didn't deserve this kind of punishment. But see, sometimes it's not our fault. God allows certain obstacles to come to test our faith.
Yes.
To grow your trust so that we are strong enough to carry what he has for us. You may only have the faith of the mustard seed, and that's okay. God can still use that to move mountains.
Right. Yes.
He allowed it for a reason. Have faith even when life isn't going your way. So let's recap a little bit. Number one, faith is believing for the best even when things look the worst. We read the reference of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Number two, faith is knowing God's got you even when life doesn't go your way. We use references of both Job and Joseph, and how when life was just throwing them a bunch of storms, they had to have faith that God would get them out, and because of that, they received such a huge reward from God.
Yeah.
And now we're at number three. Faith is trusting that God can help you recover from your sins. I like to think of this as the story of Jacob. Jacob was a man who was favored by his mother Rebekah. They had a plan to take Esau's blessing that his father Isaac was supposed to give him. When he made the decision to betray his father and brother, he was blessed in the moment but had to run from his sin.
Mm. Yes.
As time passed, Jacob just got tired of running. He had to trust God that not only he would forgive him, but that his brother would forgive him.
Woo, that's good.
Amen. Yeah. Come on now.
That's good.
Have you ever had a plan to sin? Did you ever sin on purpose? Was it ever a conscious choice?
Yes.
It felt good at the moment,
right? But
then you started having to run. Running. Pray and ask God for forgiveness. Repent and sin no more. God's mercy is full and he's quick to forgive.
Yes, he is.
God has already cast your sin into the sea of forgetfulness.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
If he woke you up this morning, you are new. Walk in that.
Amen.
Whom the Son has set free is free indeed.
Amen.
Don't let the enemy lie to you that you are not forgiven.
Amen.
Once again, we're recapping. Number one, faith is believing for the best even when things look the worst. Number two, faith is knowing God's got you even when life doesn't go your way. Number three, faith is trusting that God can help you recover from your sins. And number four, faith is trusting something that looks impossible. This I use as a reference of Jesus Christ and his life. Because most of the things he did in his life were impossible.
Yes,
and he had to submit faith to God.
Yes.
He fasted for 40 days and never gave up. Although he was fully God, he was still fully man.
Yes.
So he had to go through the same struggles that we go through every single day.
Yeah.
Even when the devil tried to knock him off course and tempt him, he believed that his father was greater than anything the world could give him. But back then, and this is a little secret, healing people from sick and raising people from the dead wasn't normal. But by his faith, he received power from his father to perform miracles and signs and wonders displayed to show God's glory. Jesus had to pay the ultimate price. He died on the cross for us.
That's good. That's good.
He didn't want to do it. He didn't have to.
That's right.
But because he trusted God's perfect plan, he set the captives free.
Yeah. That's good.
We are fully human, but the Spirit dwells in us. The devil will try to knock you off course. He did the impossible, but said we would do greater things still. Yeah. Jesus died, and we are to daily die to our sin.
Fleshly.
Sometimes we don't want to do it because of faith, we are set free, and with our lives, encourage others to be set free as well. Even when it's hard, know He's faithful to complete what He started in you.
Amen.
So let's recap one more time. Number one, faith is believing for the best, even when things look the worst.
All right.
The reference of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And how they were put in the fiery furnace, but they trusted God to get them out. Number two, faith is knowing God's got you, even when life doesn't go your way. We use the references of Job and Joseph, and how they had to trust God to get them out of their situation, even when they felt like they didn't deserve it. And because of that, they had a huge reward given to them.
Amen.
Number three, faith is trusting that God can help you recover from your sins. We use the story of Jacob and how he sinned by taking his brother's blessing, but ended up receiving forgiveness and even more blessing that God gave him.
Yeah.
Four, faith is trusting something that looks impossible. We use the reference just now of Jesus Christ and the miracles he performed and the sacrifices he made for us. And now we're at number five. Faith helps grow your relationship with God.
Yeah. Come on now.
That's good. That's good.
Remember what I told y'all earlier that I was going to share a little bit more about our story? Well, here we go. Recently, my family has just lost our home. We thankfully have had kind friends who took us in. We have been fighting this battle for 6 years. And each time the battle got tougher, but our family stood together.
Yes, Lord.
We prayed to God and made our family stronger. It has also grown our relationship with God, knowing that He's going to make a way out of no way.
Come on now.
It's good. It's good.
He has already blessed us with a new home, and it's better than we ever dreamed or imagined.
Come on now.
Are you fighting a battle? Has it been a long time? Hold strong. Two or more gathered together makes a difference.
Yeah.
No matter how hard it gets, believe that God is right there with you, and the battle is not yours. His.
Come on now. Yes.
Our family has had to be fully submissive to God for Him to bless us.
Come on, that's good.
But without faith, it is impossible to please Him.
Yes. Yeah.
Look to Him. Trust Him. Don't worry about what you can't see. God can see it all.
Yeah.
And He's got everything under control. It will work out together for your good and His glory. Alright, I'm going to wrap this up, but I still have something I want to tell you all. Faith is stepping out of your comfort zone.
That's
what I'm doing right now. So uncomfortable. But when it's doing something to the will of God, you're going to make it through.
Amen.
To be honest, I've actually had a pretty hard week this week. If anybody can tell you, we had 5 tests, had a project to turn in, football practice every day, and a game. Pressing forward, pressing through today, so that I can inspire others to have faith. Faith will free you from all the weight on your shoulders. God takes you through things, not just for you, not just for you, but so you can help someone else.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Do not be ashamed to tell your story.
Come on now.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. There is no shame or condemnation in Jesus. He knows our weakness, and we have faith. And we have faith He will turn that into strength.
Yeah.
There is
yeah.
power in your testimony.
Come on now.
You are blessed to be a blessing.
Yeah.
Moses lived in a palace. Not because he was awesome, but because God put him there. Where has God placed you to be awesome? Have you felt yourself getting comfortable? I know we were comfortable in our old home. At the chosen time, He will call you out of that comfortable place to use your life for others. At the chosen time, God will use you for something great.
Yes.
God told Moses to talk to Pharaoh. But you know what Moses did? He went, not me. You can't use me, Lord. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do. I don't know if He's going to listen to me. I just killed a man in Egypt. I don't have the qualifications, Lord. Well, guess what? God already knew He was going to be acting a fool.
Preach, man, preach.
Hey, don't we all, right? There's some point in our life we always act a fool in front of God. He always makes a way.
Yes, He does. Yeah. Here's the good part, though. Aaron's staff
Aaron's staff swallowed up their staff.
Amen.
Proving God was more powerful.
Yes.
Amen.
The enemy has power only if you let him have
That's
power.
Right.
That's right.
Amen.
And I am not a perfect being. But God has way more power.
Yes.
Knowing God was with them, Moses asked Pharaoh to let his people go with boldness and confidence. God will show you little signs and wonders along the way to build your faith. To build your faith for your big miracle.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
We want many court battles and appeals along the way that reminded us God was fighting our battles. And he gave us little tastes of victory to increase our faith.
Yeah.
Just a sidebar, Moses was 80 and just getting started. For those of you who think it's too late for you, you can still make a difference.
Please
no
say
where
that.
You're at in your life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right.
Pharaoh had a stubborn heart and refused to obey. Moses went to him 9 more times. He did not give up. He was relentless. Pharaoh still refused to listen though. Therefore, God had to reveal himself more and more until eventually Pharaoh gave in and let the Israelites go. So if you are relentless, no matter how many times you have to step out of your comfort zone, it won't be easy, but God will give you brothers and sisters, blood brothers and sisters, because Christ that he is raising up with you to fight with, and you will eventually be victorious. He led the Israelites when slavery had become their comfort zone, and led them to freedom by parting the Red Sea and allowing them to walk on dry land. Only Jesus can break the bonds of sin. Someone in your life is facing something where they are afraid of getting out of comfort, afraid of drowning. God has called you to lead them to dry land, where their promises are waiting. Lead them to freedom. Lead them to faith. Lead them to Jesus.
Amen. Yeah.
So, if you haven't taken much out of this, remember this. Faith is believing for the best, even when things look the worst. Faith is knowing God's got you, even when life doesn't go your way. Faith is trusting that God can help you recover from your sins. Faith is trusting something that looks impossible. Faith helps you grow your relationship with God. So I'm going to ask you a few more questions before I leave. How much are you willing to fight to receive all that God has for you?
Mm.
Are you ready to have faith when your world goes upside down?
I'm scared.
Are you willing to believe in God's promises? How you answer these questions will determine how fast you allow faith to set you free. Let's pray.
Mm.
Dear Heavenly Father God, we thank you, Lord, for this time. Yes. We thank you, Lord, for allowing us to have the opportunity, Lord, to understand that faith will set us free, God, from any situation that we may have, God.
Yeah.
We thank you, Lord, that there's so many examples in the Bible about people who've had to have faith in tough times, Lord, and that you've gotten them out of it, God, and that you've given them such huge rewards, and that you've used them for such mighty things to grow your kingdom. Father God, help us to continue to be vessels, God. Help us to grow your kingdom, Lord, more and more each day. And as we walk out of this church building, Lord, we ask that we continue to grow our faith so that our relationship can be stronger, God.
Yes.
And Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this time we have. We ask that you have your way in your son's name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.